The NASCAR Xfinity Series heads to Kansas for their last regular season race. So the big question is, who gets in? One of the drivers fighting for a spot in the playoffs is Parker Kligerman. Parker, you're just minus 1 point. So there's a points battle on the line, but there's also some guys that could come in and just win it. Is this, to this point in your career, the biggest race of your career?
Definitely the most on the line, Kim. And I think the thing that really sticks out to me is that I just haven't been in a position, you know, when I was at Daytona and I had that, the end of that race where there was, you know, so many objectives for the cars around me. I don't know if I've really been in this position in my career, because up until this point, I really have only ever raced in a traditional championship format. And so, you know, there is a lot going on, right? And it is a pressure packed situation. But I think for myself and my race team, you know, we've kind of been in this mode for the last 4 or 5 weeks. So it doesn't feel any different. You know, going into Daytona, I approached that as a must win, you know, cutoff in my mind. And I felt that whole week, I thought, you know, and how I approached it mentally was, you got to win this race and you got to do everything you can to have max stage points, because I felt like that was the only way to bring the intensity needed to go and have the performance we needed under the pressure that we were under. So, you know, that's how I'm approaching this weekend. In my opinion, although it's a very close points battle, the best way for me as a competitor to approach the weekend is to think, I want to go out there and win both stages and win the race. And if I do that, then points don't matter, right? Now, if we don't have the speed, we make those assessments as we go through, whatever it is, but have that intensity, that focus, and that drive, and that mindset of having the best performance possible, staying locked in the whole time, executing at a high level, and, you know, may the best team and driver come out on top if it comes down to points. We'll see. You know, one thing I do want to point out, and I'm not just saying this because he's on the call on this with us, but Steve did have a great quote a couple years ago with the regular season finale at Daytona, which said, and I've always loved it ever since, and he said, if you need this race to get in the playoffs, shame on you. And if you look at our race team and what we've done this year, to be honest, and being my harshest critic, you know, and our harshest critic, we haven't been perfect. We haven't, you know, we haven't scored enough stage points throughout this season. We've had things that have really set us back and put us in this position that we need this race to get in the playoffs. So shame on us, but the bright side of that is we've had our best speed in the last 10 weeks. We have executed a high level. And I think if we do exactly what we've done the last 10 weeks, we'll find ourselves going into the playoffs here.
Well, Parker, that's a good transition, because I do want to point that out, that when I look at this race, this is a body of the regular season. This is one race to decide, but it took a lot of races to get here. So my analysis of what we're going to see really comes down to the stages. I do think there's an outside chance Brandon Jones could upset everyone with a win, because I'm shocked that they haven't run better. I'm shocked that the 8 doesn't have a win, but Brandon Jones out of Junior Motorsports can win. He has won at Kansas before, and while we haven't seen winning speed, it can show up. You know, you can unload and all of a sudden have it. No real cup regulars in the field. I think that makes the 9 more dangerous. So now to your situation, though, I believe this is all about stage points. I think that you and Riley will both show up. I think the playoff pressure will push you guys to be your best. And I think you're going to finish within a spot or two of one another. So is that a fair assumption? Am I looking at it correctly? And from behind the wheel, are you putting the same emphasis at the end of those stages where, you know, look, 7th to 11th is big because it's 0 versus 3 or 4 points. So it can be a big swing in the stages.
No, you're 100% right. And if you look at our regular season so far, you know, I like to make a joke that we're the kings of 11th place finishes in the stages, because we have been. We just, for whatever reason, whether it's qualifying that set us back, we driven through the field to get to 11th, or bad pit stops that set us back in stage 2, and we get all the way back to 11th. I haven't seen the stats, but I swear there's no possibility that anyone has finished 11th more often than us in these stages this year. So that has definitely been our weak point. And if you look at last week at Darlington, you know, Riley, we out-qualified him, but he was able to get ahead of me on a restart that held that position about 2 cars ahead of us. We got close to him at the end of stage 1, but didn't get the stage points. We get into stage 2. We have a decent stop that gets us right up to him. We're catching his group of cars towards the middle of the stage. And then we have a loose wheel from that pit stop that set us back, and we end up finishing 11th in that stage. So to me, that is a microcosm of our season that we just haven't executed in the stages. By the time we got to the third stage, we drove to the field and we're in position to have a great finish. So we've done that a lot. How can we minimize that? Well, it starts in qualifying, right? I think last week we actually had some of our best practice speed. We'll repeat two on the board in practice. Qualifying, we repeat 13, but, you know, really just a little difference from me in turn four. And I think we're probably qualifying sixth to eighth. So that was, I felt like some speed that we just hadn't seen this year. And then if I look at the average race pace speed from last week, we were seventh. So we were the seventh fastest car in the series at a downforce track. That's the best we've been all year. The 98 was ninth. So we know we can beat that team, but we've got to out execute them in those early stages. And the stages are tough because they're short runs. They require, you know, where you restart and how aggressive you are on the restart and where you slot yourself in there really pays off because they're short 45 lap runs or less than 45 laps in stage two. So it's really tough, you know, in that sense, if you don't have the track position to make it up. And so for us, we've just got to execute from the first lap on track in practice through qualifying. And if we can get that early track position in stage one, I believe we can hold on to it. And that's really what it's going to come down to. I think you're right there.
Hey, Kim, and what I'll just add, and I'll say it right here in front of Parker, the one thing that I think is going to make this even better is when Riley got done last week in his interview, he said, that's fine, and this is fine, and that's fine, but we want to win. And the fact that he wasn't talking about points or the playoffs, the fact that his goal in his interview was, I want to win, I do think is the right mentality. And that's what's going to make this a real heavyweight fight for the last spot.
Well, the last spot in the playoffs isn't the only battle. We also have to crown a regular season champion in the series. Right now, Austin Hill, 23 points above John Hunter Nemechek. They have just exchanged blows all season long at the top of that point standing. So, Parker, you've raced against them all season long. Who's your money on to take home the regular season championship?
Ooh, you know, it has been tight, and those two have been so equal, and what it proves is you need either a car number in the 20 or 21 range to be at the front of the Xfinity Series field in 2023. I'm sorry, that's a stupid joke, but no, they have been really even, and when I look at, you know, what Austin Hill and that 21 team have accomplished, one thing they've done so much better than they did last year was at the road courses, at the downforce tracks. They have brought a level of speed and execution in a lot of respects that I don't think they had last year, whereas the 20 and Joe Gibbs Racing continues to show immense speed at short tracks and downforce tracks. I think they have that advantage going into this weekend. But what the 21 team does better than any team right now in the series is execute. And if you look at their races, they have been in positions where they barely have a car that's fast enough to be in the top 10, yet they out-execute everyone on pit road. They have the right strategies. Austin does a great job on restarts, and there they find themselves with a top five finish, or even at Pocono competing for a win and getting that win. So, you know, that team to me with a 23 point buffer, and if they bring the same level of execution they bring for what they've brought for this last, you know, the most of this regular season, I don't think it's going to be easy for the 20 team to use their speed advantage to beat the 21.
I think it's simple. It's been a monster week for John Hunter. He's going back to the Cup Series, driving for Legacy in a Toyota. I think he's going to be super fast at Kansas. I think he wins the race. He's my prediction. And it's going to be too little, too late. I think the 21 car will stay too close, 23 points. Much like the bubble, the regular season championship is a body of work. And I think the body of work for the 21 will carry him on to be the regular season championship. But that is going to set the stage for the Xfinity Series playoffs, and it's going to be fun.
We'll have the answers to all these questions and more. All the action from Kansas, from the Xfinity Series, Saturday, 3 p.m. Eastern on NBC and Peacock. Thanks for watching NASCAR America Motormouths, presented by Toyota.
Hi, I'm Parker Kligerman. For more access like this from Pit Road, be sure to click and subscribe to the Motorsports on NBC YouTube channel.